I have to move 5 yards of dirt into the back and fill some low spots, like over by that maple tree. And I don't have a four-wheeler anymore, or a tractor, or anything to pull this thing. So I guess I'm going to have to use it like a wheelbarrow. It's going to be difficult. Well, I'll give it a try. So, thinking about moving that dirt. I got this trailer I kept. Got rid of my four-wheeler. I don't have a tractor anymore either. I've worn it up. I've had the trailer for a good 20 years. Use it for a wheelbarrow. But I need to come up with something quick to make it more useful and less... less on my back, less work for me. It does have a pull, it does dump. So I want to come up with something, and I want to show you. Okay? So, in a while, I guess. So, here's what I came up with. I went to a store and bought this. HF store. I'm not going to advertise, you know, for them, but, you know, it's an 8-inch wheel. Got a swivel on the front. Okay. And, that's a good size. It tips, you know. And still has a dump. And what I did was I just put a couple bars across and bolted it on there. So it'll still, you know, swivel around. I haven't put a handle on it yet, but I think I'm going to do that. But it does roll pretty nice. It works pretty nice, so. So I'm going to use it like that. So that was the problem I had to solve. Now, I'm also going to put a handle on the front. I'm going to probably look at my tools, see if I can take something apart and bolt it on the front and use it for like a steering handle. So I'm going to take care of that next. Well, I found this tool that I haven't used in a long time. It does scrapes floor tiles or roofing shingles. It's just a big scraper. I took the blade off of it. But it does have two holes. As you can see, I'm transferring them onto this tape. So I can then whip that off. And line it up on the front here. You know, tape it on there and drill some holes. And then I'm going to have it extending past the dolly wheel. And that'll give me some more leverage to steer it and also pull it. And if I need to come up from here and put a strap around that, if it moves around too much, then I will do that. So that'll be the next thing. After I figured out where I want this bar to go, I drilled some holes. Now I gotta drill the holes bigger. And the holes gotta be bigger, so what I'm gonna do is use this like reverse a bit, which works really, really good. Here's what I ended up doing. I put bolts with washers so I can shim it up, but you know, you can go out and buy the right size. I put a piece of wood underneath the cross up against the bolts. So when I tighten it down, there's no empty space. There is a groove in this tool where the blade goes. And what I'm going to do is try to squish that into that so it like keeps it straight. We'll see how stiff it is. If it's not stiff enough, then I'm going to have to come up with an upright to fasten to this. Or I'm going to have to go to the corner, each corner, like at a diagonal to the corner, and then to that corner, if you can know what I mean. And then, like, have a strap on it or something. Maybe I could probably use conduit and clamp it to this. We'll see. So here's my trailer, my trailer wheelbarrow. All right, I have the handle on it. Can roll around, pull it. I just want to put some reinforcement arms down at an angle, probably down at an angle like this, or to the corner, and then up, bend them, conduit, and then just clamp the conduit on here. And I think that would take care of the back and forth and the up and down. So I'm going to take care of that, and then I'll be back. All right, now I need a 24-inch of half-inch conduit. I'm going to flatten one side and bend it. I need two the same, and then I'll figure out how I'm going to hook it up here. That's a 24-inch one, but, you know, onto here. I want to bend it and clamp it is what I want, because I want to be able to take it off and use this tool if I need it. When you get these cut 24 inches each, you want to bend them sort of in the socket. Now, the other end is not going to matter as long as you've got these approximately the same. Because what you want to do is you're going to put it underneath this arm. You're going to put them side by side underneath, and then you're going to put two clamps on it. Then you're going to have to drill some holes in the other end and then use some self-tapping, or you could drill it out and put some bolts in it. That'll keep it from going side to side and up and down. So tighten those clamped up as tight as you can get them. They'll loosen up as these pipes, you know, I got a quarter of an inch sticking out. So they start loosening, squeezing together. Now what you want to do is maybe put these in the middle of this spacer, but at least it looks like maybe 8 inches away from the center. Same with the other one. Then I'm going to mark them, drill a hole through them, and then screw them to that bottom lip. Then I should be able to see right now, this will work good back and forth, but I can't lift the dump. So what I need to do is fasten that tight. After you mark the holes, center punch them, drill them. I use a vise, but, you know, be careful, safety glasses. And gloves work really good. And then after you get done drilling it, you're going to put it back on there. And then you're going to finish drilling through the hole at whatever such angle is straight. And then you're going to put in the screws. That's pretty straight. That's done. So what I did was I hose clamped this. I'm going to tighten down those hose clamps. And I put bottle cap ends on, and I drilled the hole on that lip. Same with that one. But I pre-drilled the top holes. And, of course, I've got that scraper bolted on there. And when you get out here, it really turns. So I feel satisfied that's going to be pretty good. And the other thing is, if I put this rope up here, I have to pull that rope lift this up. Even though that goes pretty high, I can still grab it when it's empty and pull it down, flip it. I would let it go up by itself, or I would lift it by grabbing here, you know, at this joint. And just have to be out of the way. And you want to load it so a little bit of the load is to the front. So there's a little bit of weight on the wheel. Not a lot, but just enough. And then you can load the back also. And, you know, that should work. I'm going to go out and try it out and see how it works. If you don't have this lift, you're going to have to put an angle iron across there or something, just enough to bolt your angle bracket to. Now we're going to go out and try to dump it and see how it works out. It is all done. It's on the dump mode. And it works great.